Okay, so two post-game really important stretches. If we get you to do anything, these are super important, hip flexors and hamstrings. So hip flexors, right in here, okay? You need them to be long and strong for that full length stride. Okay, if they're short, you won't be able to get a full push behind as you're in the middle of your stride, right? And you can get tension on your low back because they come up attached on your low back. If they're tight, they pull you into this position. So we need to lengthen them out so you can stay nice and tight in the core. So here's an important stretch for the hip flexors. Okay, Eric's gonna get down one knee in front, his back knee down, and he's gonna turn this glute on to help push his hip forward, but he's not arching in his low back. He's staying nice, tight, front of the ribs, glute is on, and just pushing forward with the glute. And then to increase the stretch, he can reach his arm up overhead, feel it pull up a little higher there. Okay, so he's gonna hold that for about 45, 60 seconds. Just judge that based on however you're feeling. We want the muscle to relax in that position, hold for a little longer, and then we'll switch sides. So same thing on the other side. He's not gonna demo that though. We'll get into the hamstring stretch. So after you're done both sides and the hip flexors, you can even do this with your gear on, just right after the game, whatever works for you, okay? So hamstring stretch is gonna squeeze, grab onto his hamstring, and then kick his heel to the sky. So toe back to his head, heel to the sky, hold for 1 second, and just kick up, using his quad to kick up, and you'll feel a good pull on the hamstring. Gonna go about 10 aside there, reaching the heel to the sky, toe to the head. Okay, really important for those of you who didn't get a 3 on your movement screen, we wanna really improve that hamstring mobility. Just get the most out of your stride on those.